Good morning, I'm Kevin Owens with Kamado Joe. I want to thank All Cape Appliance for having me down today to demonstrate the Kamado Joe ceramic barbecue grill and show the Cape Codders how to get to know a different form of cooking, per se. I'm going to show you how to light it and tell you a little bit about it so you're familiar with it, and then we'll get some cooking going and demonstrate it. This is an all-ceramic barbecue grill that weighs approximately 200 pounds. The secret to it is the ceramics. It's nice and thick. It's basically the same principle as the tiles that are in the space shuttle. It doesn't expand and contract, it'll hold your heat, and it will not dry out your food. When you get starting with this, it's not like your dad's old charcoal grill. It's not where you have to pour lighter fluid in, it's hard to start, mom doesn't want to use it, none of that stuff. This is really simple. My wife uses it. Once you play with it a little bit for once or twice, you'll have it down pat. What you do to start with, you'll come out, it's closed. This is your daisy wheel top. You'll go ahead and open that up fully. And down here is your bottom airflow vent. Go ahead and open that up fully. That way you've got nice airflow going. You open it up. You take your grate out. And just set it for the side for a minute. And this uses a natural wood charcoal. It doesn't use a briquette. A briquette's made more out of oil or petroleum, and it's not really a natural product. This uses all natural wood, if you will. It's just like chunks of wood. Little pieces of campfire wood. You take and you fill this up to where the two pieces meet inside. There's a firebox and a fire ring, and you'll see a seam. You pour this charcoal in. And I put enough charcoal in here now to cook probably 14 hours. When I finish today, I can just shut the air off and you can relight it. Use it over and over and over again. You light it with these. These are little fire starters, and they're made basically out of compressed sawdust. All natural, no chemicals, nothing to make the food smell bad. You take four of them, four squares. You put one in each quadrant on top and bury it down in the charcoal a little bit. Then you just take a normal lighter or a long lighter, whatever you have, light the squares. Once you get it lit, you just kind of let it go for about a minute and you'll see it catch. And you'll know it's got a nice catch on it. Then you'll shut it down and the temperature will start climbing. You can bring it up to about 500 to 600 degrees in about 12 minutes. And from there, you choke it down, start choking the air down. Say you want to cook overnight. You just start getting your airflow low and the temperature will go down and you can set it and forget it. You can put your pork butt on or your ribs and just walk away from it. If you want to do steaks, you just bring the temperature on up to about 800 degrees, sear them really quick, and you can cook them just like they do at your restaurant, like a Ruth Chris or a nice restaurant. If you want to do wood-fired pizzas, you leave it about 550. You get it going, you put your pizza stone in, get the stone nice and hot, and you can do wood-fired pizzas all night long. When you finish, like I say, you just shut it down, shut your air off, and you walk away from it, it goes right out. And that's as simple as that. By the time you have a cocktail and take your shoes off, you're ready to cook.
Well, I can smell that wood fire going. Hi, Kevin.
Hey, John, how are you?
I'm fine. I was on the road here, and I just thought I'd stop by here at All Cape Appliances. I get the aromas coming out there, man, I'll tell you.
It'll make it smell down the block, man, I'll tell you.
You betcha.
My neighbors, they peek over the fence constantly.
Now, what are you preparing here for me?
Right now, I'm doing some coffee rub pork chops with a blueberry barbecue sauce.
Blueberry barbecue sauce.
Blueberry barbecue sauce. I basically take my barbecue sauce and I add fresh blueberries to it.
Oh, nice.
Gives it a nice flavor. Whatever fruit's local, though, if it's like peach season or strawberries or raspberries or cranberries, whatever's fresh, I'll put into the barbecue sauce.
Oh, my.
Whatever you like. If you don't like blueberries, do something else.
And this is actually something that you've developed, or you just...
It's kind of picked up from different people. We all cook together, change ideas, and...
Yeah. You travel all throughout the Northeast, South and Southwest, South.
I do. I've been all over the country with this barbecue. I'm a Kansas City barbecue judge, and I've been to Kansas City, Texas,
Fantastic.
I'm from the Carolinas and, of course, up here. And I found some really good barbecue up here.
You're here on Cape Cod.
Cape Cod.
And you can do actually fish on this, too, I'm sure.
Oh,
nice salmon.
Do a lot of fish. Salmon.
Trout.
I do striper, trout.
Oh, nice. Yeah.
Yeah, fresh fish is awesome.
And you were mentioning that you could smoke with this, too, right?
Overnight? Oh, yeah. You can do true smoking with this.
Uh-huh.
You know, you just set your temperature, get it where you want to go, and walk away from it. It'll cook all night long.
What's the weight of this?
This thing is heavy. It weighs about 200 pounds.
Uh-huh.
200 pounds.
So I don't have to take it in during hurricane season?
No. Uh-huh. I've actually seen buildings burn down, and this will be the only thing still standing.
Oh, my. No. One of the favors, of course, I'll have when I have one of these in my home, I'm going to make a lot of friends and neighbors very happy.
Yes.
They'll be coming, I'm sure.
Yes. I haven't operated a snowblower since I've lived in the Northeast.
Uh-huh.
My neighbors bring their turkey over, I cook it, they snowblow the driveway, you know.
That's a good way of doing it.
When the power's out, they come to my house, they know I can cook their food for them.
Yeah.
Get it ready.
And this comes in many sizes, too.
It comes in two sizes.
Uh-huh.
This is your large size, and then back in the background here, we have what's called the Big Joe. It's more of a competition-type size.
Sure.
You can cook maybe 8 beer can chickens on that, or 7 rib racks at one time.
Yeah, I like that beer can chicken holder. I've used that even in my oven, you know, not only just here, but there.
Beer can chicken is very popular. With that holder, you can actually put your own mixture, your own flair into it.
Yeah, I'm gonna try it not only just with chicken. I think I mentioned to you some time ago that I can do a pot roast or a nice pork roast.
Absolutely.
With that.
Absolutely. Anything you get in there, the moisture is going to cook it from underneath and flavor it. So anything you can put up there, wrap it, tie it, and put it on, it'll cook fine.
And Kamado is not just only for the ceramic grill. But you do have others.
No, we do make a line of gas grills, and we have a combination unit that has a gas grill and a Kamado on one side. For the people, if you want convenience of gas sometimes, or there's certain foods you just like to cook on gas, you have it. So you put your turkey on your Kamado, and then you cook it on your gas. But we have gas, we have different carts, different outdoor kitchen designs, the whole outdoor backyard. We cook.
And there's really no assembly to this. It comes as is, right?
It comes completely assembled, ready to go. It may take 5 minutes to pull the plastic off.
5 minutes to, and get going cooking, huh?
That's it. You ready to go?
Yeah. Does Kamado Joe have a website?
We do. It's kamadojoe.com.
Okay. So if you'd like more information about Kamado Joe, and of course here at All Cape Appliances, you can find a nice display of not only just the ceramic, but your full gas grill.
Exactly. Yeah. Exactly.
But after having the aromas of the wood fire, you know, nothing like it. No. Nothing like it.
Nothing like it.
Yeah. And again, the preparation of the pork chops today, what was you were using the bacon for some reason?
I did. To start with, I did a little recipe. It's from the South. I picked up. It's called pig candy.
Pig candy.
You take a nice thick slice of bacon.
Uh-huh.
And you put brown sugar on it. I like to use a cane sugar.
Yeah.
And some cayenne pepper.
Mm-hmm.
You coat it, put it on there, flip it after about 3 minutes, coat the other side, and it's done.
Yeah.
Just a different variation on bacon.
Yeah, maybe I can add my bourbon, my whiskey to it, too.
Absolutely.
Kick it up a notch.
Absolutely.
Now, do you kick it up a notch with any kind of spices, that blueberry?
It depends on what I'm trying to do.
Yeah, you want sweet.
Sweet. If you got heat, you want sweet.
Do you think I can try some of this, Kevin?
Absolutely.
Sure. Let me have one anyway.
Absolutely.
And I've got to have the sauce on it, right?
Got to have some of the sauce.
Oh, okay. Let me put it right here. One anyway. I'm going to cut this up and enjoy it. But can I get a little of the sauce, too?
Absolutely.
Sure, just a little tad here. Okay. Cut it up, and doesn't that look good? Oh, man, I'm ready for this. Now, again, if anybody was interested in knowing more about Kamado Joe, they can come here and at All Cape Appliances.
Come right here at All Cape Appliances,
and
they'll have it.
Find out.
They use them themselves.
I think we should do more demonstrations, because can I have you here again?
Absolutely.
Sure, I'd love
to. I plan to be here several times during the summer.
Yeah, I'm going to give a shot of this, okay?
Absolutely.
Well, I want to thank you for coming here at All Cape Appliances. I guess I'm only going to have one piece.
I want to thank you guys for inviting me out and having me out today.
You
to
bet.
Learn about the Kamado Joe.
Well, I guess when you snooze, you lose, but I'm just going to have one little taste of this Kamado Joe's barbecue pork chops. And thank you again, Kevin.
Thank you very much for having
me. You're welcome.
Taste all right?
I'm going to marry you.